Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm on a Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to create a simple Hello World Python program and how to run that within PyCharm. So do watch the video till the end. If you're facing any issues, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install latest version of PyCharm, it first simply go to the browser and to search over here PyCharm download, hit enter. So that will show you this www.jetbrains.com. So just simply click on this download button and it's going to show you this official site of JetBrains. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description. Once when you are here, you will see that there are two options that are available. One is PyCharm Professional, and when you scroll down, you will get PyCharm Community Edition. Alright, so I'm going to download the Community Edition and that too for Windows. So when you click on this drop down, you can see that it is available for, you know, .exe of Windows and also .exe of Windows ARM. So select this .exe Windows and click on this download button, and that will show you this thank you for downloading PyCharm, and our PyCharm is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our PyCharm Community Edition is already been downloaded over here. So simply double click on this installer to install it locally on our system. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and welcome to PyCharm Community Edition setup. So simply click on next over here. So this is where our PyCharm is going to be installed. Just keep it default. Only thing you need to check is this available space required. So currently I have 163 GB of free space, which is sufficient enough to install just 2 GB of PyCharm. So just check this and click on next. So here under installation options, you will see all these different options. I'll recommend you to select each and every option over here. So this is the most important one, to select this bin folder to path. This is very important, don't forget to select this. And also we are going to code on Python, so that's why I'm selecting this .py. And also this option selecting will help you to, you know, open any folder on PyCharm, so that's why I'm going to select that. And this is just a desktop shortcut, so selecting that will create a desktop shortcut, so that will help you to, you know, open PyCharm at ease. Just keep everything as selected and click on next. So it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is totally fine. Click on install. So our installation is rightly began, you can clearly see, right? So let's minimize our download directory and wait for some time. And by this time, when PyCharm get installed, I'll also request you to subscribe our channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. You can always subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax if you want. And if you are also interested to learn about WordPress, so you can always watch all these videos on our channel. Alright, so basically you can watch this entire playlist. So some videos are 1 hour, some are 1 or 30 minute video, some videos are in series. If you want to create a portfolio website, you can create that. So all these different videos are available on our channel for completely free. So if you're interested to learn about WordPress and how to create a e-commerce website and all that, don't forget to watch our playlist. And here let's wait for some time. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our PyCharm Community Edition is rightly installed. You can see the desktop shortcut also getting created over here. So here it is telling whether you like to reboot your system now or you want to manually reboot later. I'll always recommend you to reboot your system now. So just simply select that reboot your system now and click on finish to reboot your system. After successfully rebooting your system, let's again come back to this video. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, we'll be again landed over to the desktop, and here is our PyCharm Community Edition. So just simply double click on this shortcut, and that should be launching our PyCharm. So you can see PyCharm Community Edition version 2024.3 is rightly started launching, and it has rightly launched. So before that, it is telling whether you'd like to import all the settings from the previously installed software, that is IntelliJ IDEA. So you might not be installing IntelliJ IDEA, so I'll recommend you to skip import here and that will launch PyCharm, just a fresh software. Alright, let's maximize it. So now I'm going to create a Hello World Python program. So I'll just simply click on this new project. So that will open this Python new project window. Here I need to provide your project name. So let's name as Hello World. And under project version, if you click, you can see it is not showing anything. Right. So that is because you don't have Python installed on your system. Alright, I also don't have. So that's why it is not showing anything. So it's very important to install Python now. So I'll click on cancel over here. I'll close this also. I'll going to install Python first. Just open a new tab and just simply type Python download. Just quickly download latest version of Python and install that. So just simply click on this installer and select all these two options. Click on custom installation, keep everything as default, click on next and select this install Python 3.13 for all users. Install. It will accept administrative privileges. Click on yes. And our Python is rightly started installing. So let's wait for some time over here. So we'll come back and now you can clearly see that our Python is rightly installed. So just simply close this and let's launch our PyCharm community edition as well. So welcome to PyCharm. And now when you click on this new project, this time you can see it is telling loading interpreter and it has safely detected the Python that I have installed. So you can see it is showing that also, right? It is also now showing all the previous versions of Python as well. So if you want to downgrade your Python to some older version, so that also you can do. Right, so that's why it is important to install Python. Here, let's give a project name as Hello World and just simply click on create. So that going to immediately start creating our PyCharm project and it is rightly created. So let's maximize this. So here is our Hello World project. So currently you can see that it is indexing. So when you click on the show all, it shows that it is updating our Python interpreter and also updating our Python indexes. So let's wait for some more time. So we'll come back and now you can clearly see that our project is rightly set up. So everything is fine. Let's right click on our project Hello World and let's hover over new and let's create a Python file. So let's give the Python file name as main.py and just simply select a Python file, double click on it. That should be creating a main.py file over here. You can see it is actually created. So let's write some Python code snippet. So write something like Hello World. Just click on this run button after that. So that's going to immediately start building our project and going to show you the output on our console. So you can do some simple Python program, something like you can add a couple of numbers. So let's assign two values like a equal to 5 and let's say b equal to 6 and let's print summation of these two numbers like a plus b. Just write something like this and click on the run button and immediately you are getting the output 11 on our console, right? So 5 plus 6, that is 11 is showing, right? So in this way you can easily install latest version of PyCharm and you can start working on your Python projects right on PyCharm. So that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax, and also if you're interested you can always watch our WordPress videos on our channel. Alright, so you can watch all this entire playlist. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.